In the previous training video, we learned how to turn on the Track Changes feature, which means anytime that anybody makes any changes to your document, it'll keep track of it. And in this example, I asked Mr. Humphreys to make some changes as well, so you can see the difference between his changes and comments and mine. So first off, I've got the first change. When I hover over it, you can see in the pop-up, that's me. I made the change, and what did I do? You can see in the pop-up, inserted the add text text. And then when I go to the next one, hover over it, well, it's got a comment that's tied to the change, so it's just going to display the comment when I hover over it and not the actual, well, change. And if I'd like to see the change, not the comment, well, you can do one of a couple of things. First off, when you insert a comment, don't tie it to the text that you are changing, which really doesn't make any sense because you do want to make a comment about what you changed, at least I do. And the other option, which makes more sense to me, is to come up here and click on the Review tab, go to the tracking group, and do not show your comments. Go ahead and uncheck it. The comments are gone, or they're hidden. So when you hover over it, now it doesn't display the comment, but the actual change. As it says in the pop-up, I deleted the word night. Let's go ahead and show those comments, bring them back, and let's go to the next change. Got one right here. Hover over it, and you can see that Mr. Humphrey says in the pop-up, or you can read it over here in the comment over to the far right, he wants me to use adversities as opposed to the word hardships, and, well, he'd like to see the hardships removed. And then down below that, we just have a comment tied to that entire paragraph. And in the pop-up, he says, fabulous, babes, or, well, fabulous imagery. And then down below that, there's some changes, but who made them? Okay, Mr. Humphreys, but no comment. So he inserted, well, it looks like maybe a space, and then the E. Oh, he added an E. Oh, that's nice. Now, when it comes to going through your document, going from change to change and trying to identify, well, this is so tiny here, it's hard to really see that there was a change. What can help you out is, well, with the cursor flashing up at the top of the document, is to come up here and go to the changes group. And you can go from change to change, and it also includes comments. So when I click on next, it goes to the first change and it highlights it, and I can identify it going, oh, that's a change. Hover over it, learn more about it, and then I can click next. To go to the next change, click next, and then it goes from that change to the comment. And I can go ahead and go previous. So, you know, if I'm in the middle of the document and I go from that point down by clicking on next, there you go. And or go up by clicking on previous, well, go for it. You can do that to jump around. You can also, let me go ahead and click at the beginning, click on the accept or reject options. When you click on the accept drop-down arrow, you can accept and move to the next text. Well, I don't have any text that I have selected that has changed for me to accept. So when I just go ahead and click on this, it takes me to the next text, at which point I can go ahead and click on the drop-down arrow and accept the change and then move to the next change, or just simply stay put and accept the change and not move anywhere else, or accept all changes within the document, or accept all and then stop the tracking, which, you know, I'm going to go ahead and stop it right now, so that way, if I want to add anything else, it doesn't keep track of the changes I make. I'd like to do my own thing here. So you got that for accepting, or you can just go ahead and click on the accept button once it goes right to that change to accept or reject, or you can go ahead and click on the reject drop-down arrow because, you know, if you don't want it, then go ahead and get rid of it. You can pretty much do the same thing. Reject, move to the next change, reject the change and stay put. You get the option to reject all changes shown, but I don't get that yet. And then reject all changes, and reject all changes and stop tracking. So for this one, the text add text, I'm going to reject the change and move to the next change. And you can see it got rid of it, so it no longer has the add text text. And it goes to this one, and let's see, strobing the night. I don't like night, please use something else. Well, you know what? I'd like to reject that, click on the reject button, and then it goes to the comment saying, okay, well, you rejected the change, now what about the comment that's tied to it? Do you want to go ahead and leave the comment, or go ahead and reject the comment, in which case it gets rid of it, or, let me hit undo, you can come up here and delete the comment, in which case it gets rid of it as well, so whatever works best for you, or you can just go ahead and leave the comment, because maybe it's something you want to pontificate later on, in which case, leave it as is, and maybe resolve the comments saying, look, for right now it's resolved, but I'd like to keep it for a later reference, or go ahead and make a reply to your reply and say, think about using another word. Okay, the mark resolves, so that way When I come back to the document and I want to look at the comments, I can see that this has been resolved, but why has it been resolved? Well, you can see right there, think about using another word question mark. And if I'm like, you know what, I'm done with it. Let's just go ahead and get rid of the comment completely, because after so many reviews, I'm like, I'm not using another word. You can go ahead and right click on it and delete the comment. And what's interesting is it deletes my comment, but it doesn't delete the entire comment here. So make sure you're careful about where you're right-clicking. So if I want to get rid of the entire comment, well, with it selected here, you can see up here in the comments group, you got, well, the delete comment. You can also click on the drop-down arrow and delete this one, delete all comments shown, or delete all comments in the document. Well, I won't do that. Let's just go ahead and delete this one. So with the right-click on the actual comment here, well, it's the only comment. If I had replies and I right-clicked on the reply, it would delete the reply, but since it's just a single comment, no other replies, when I delete it, it gets rid of it completely. So let's go ahead and go to the next change, and we can accept or reject that. Years, pain and hardships, use adversities, forget it, reject, and then it goes to the comment, and I can reply and say, no way, I like hardships. And then go ahead and resolve it, or, you know, you can delete it. It just depends on how you want to manage your document. Maybe you want to go ahead and send this back to him as a review to show him that, hey, I'm going to stick with hardships. It's resolved. You can still see the comment. And if you disagree, go ahead and reopen it and type in something else. And then send it back to me, and I can further consider what you're going through here. And if I made a mistake and I'm like, no, I don't want to have my comment here, again, make sure you know where you're right-clicking, because, you know, if I right-click on Mr. Humphreys here and delete the entire comment, it's gone. Let me hit undo, but if I right-click on my name here and delete my comment, then Mr. Humphreys stays, my comment below his, the reply, is gone. Well, let's go ahead and right-click on Mr. Humphreys and delete it. Well, you get the option to reply or to reopen. Let's go ahead and delete that and go to the next. And he says, fabulous imagery. Oh, that was nice. I can reply and say that was nice, or you know what, I'm good. Now, when it comes to the comments, you know how we're going from one change to the next, which includes the comments? You can bypass the changes and just go from one comment to the next. So if I go ahead and hit undo to bring the other comment back, and I go to the next comment, to the previous comment, again, just from comment to comment. So I can go ahead and delete that comment, go to the next comment, and delete that one. We're done with comments, but what about changes? Well, some of these changes are so teeny tiny, if I didn't know any better, I'd probably say, well, I'm done. So instead, I can go ahead and click on next and say, let's accept that change. So there's a space between so and r. I do want the e, so let's go ahead and do this. With those last two that are there, because over here on the right-hand side, that's the only line within the entire document for that line that says that changes have been made. And we have a total of two. So I can go ahead and click on the drop-down arrow and say, accept all changes. And there you go. Those last two changes have been accepted. Mission completo. I'd like to go back to page width so it fills up the entire screen. And now I can see it. And you can too. Thanks for watching. Hey, as a quick reminder, if you like my video, please give it a thumbs up. You can also click on me and subscribe to my channel to get notified of the latest videos. And for great specials on my products, please see the description below this video.